everybody, welcome back to my channel. Ya, seperti yang dijanjikan, I said in my last vlog that I will do another video before saya give birth. Now I am 37 weeks. She's gonna be here very very soon. In fact, she's gonna be here anytime soon. I don't know. Maybe tonight, maybe tomorrow, maybe minggu depan. Anyway guys, if you haven't subscribed to my channel, jangan lupa subscribe. If you haven't know me yet, my name is Azurin. I'm from Kota Kinabalu, Sabah. We are at 689 subscribers. 3 tahun since I started my YouTube channel. That was like 2 years ago. Ever imagine that saya punya subscriber akan bertambah sampai 600 lebih? Because at first I just wanna do this as suka-suka saja, but well, here we are today. Jadi alang-alang lah. Jadi alang-alang lah kita sampaikan channel ini ke 1000 subscriber. Okay? Jadi jangan lupa subscribe. I am so excited today untuk bikin ini video. It's been 9 months since I find out that saya pregnant. Here I am today waiting for my baby to pop out. And also the reason why saya excited untuk buat di video is because I get to pakai makeup, I get to pakai anting-anting. It's been a while since I put anything on my face. I feel so alive when I see my face pakai makeup. Okay, so for today's video, I'm gonna show you guys what I pack for my hospital bag. Some of you guys had been requesting ini video. Yang DM di Instagram, ada yang DM di Facebook. Okay, let's buka balik ya. Okay, so first of all, this is the bag that I will bring pergi hospital nanti. Dan juga berapa besar lah. No compartment inside, it's just satu compartment saja. This is it, color pink. This is actually I bought from my auntie. Ini dia punya anak yang punya. So I'm gonna start with dia punya barang mandian. Saya taruh dia punya barang mandian ni di dalam ini plastik so that it won't begini-begini di dalam bag. Ada satu minyak angin. Minyak kayu putih ini actually saya punya family guna daripada dulu lagi, daripada my cousin. I don't know about me, but what I know is my cousin guna ini. Sampailah my cousin yang kecil, dan sampailah saya yang bakal beranak ni pun, saya sanggup cariin. Actually, I have a few here. I have banyak pilihan. This one. I have, mana lagi satu? Yang ni nah, minyak angin. I just beli saja semua, so that nanti kita tengok lah mana satu yang dia nak. This was actually given to me by my band masa my last day kerja. A gift from my band to me and my baby. Okay, so next one, I pack dia punya baju untuk masa di labor room nanti. I have dia punya baju lah, baju panjang tangan. Dia punya mittens, I have mitten set sini. And also I have dia punya swaddle yang ada hoodie sekali itu. Also I pack dia punya bedung. Masa beranak tuh kena kasih mandi, dan terus kena pakai ini baju. Yep, so this is it. Second one, I pack 1, 2, 3. I pack 3 baju just in case I need extra. And also I pack dia punya bows and another 2 bows over here. Jadi di dalam ni complete lah, complete dengan dia punya mittens juga ada, stockings, complete dengan dia punya topi. Because saya I might 80% lah, 80% saya akan kena seizure. So I don't know how many days I'm gonna be in the hospital because of seizure ni. I don't know. If normal mungkin 1-2 hari. Seizure, I don't know. With 3-4 days, maybe 1 week. I don't know. So that is why I pack begini banyak dia punya baju, so that I have pilihan. The next, I pack dia punya swaddle. Saya bawa 3 swaddle. 1, 2, 3. Just in case dia kesejukan. Just for dia punya swaddling lah. Dia punya selimut. Dia punya, you know. And the most important thing is dia punya towel. So, saya bawa 2 towel, 2 handkerchief ataupun sapu tangan, and then 2 lampin. I don't know if I'm gonna be using this one di sana nanti, but just in case I need to use lampin, I don't have to worry because saya sudah pack di dalam sini. So, yeah. And last sekali saya bawa yang ini. Oh no, this is not the last one. Dia punya pamper, saya bawa 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, yang tadi pun, yang di sini pun saya ada pack sekali dia punya pampers di dalam. So saya ada bawa 6, and then saya ada buat bawa betul. I do bawa dua bedung di sini, extra bedung just in case I need, which totally I will need it lah. And of course dia punya bedak, dia punya bedak, baby wipes, and dia punya botol just in case saya punya susu tidak keluar, just in case. Allah ya Tuhan, keluarkanlah air susuku untuk anakku supaya aku tidak perlu menyusukan dia daripada botol ini. I mean, so I'm gonna bring this just in case my nenen tidak berair susu. So, yep. So and then another one, selipar, buku klinik, sijil nikah, and then photo set IC saya and my husband. So, if you guys see anything kurang, just let me know in the down. So, in the down. So, if you guys see anything yang kurang, kamu boleh let me know in the comment section below. Actually, tomorrow I have a appointment di klinik to actually tengok whether the baby is still on the same position or dia sudah berubah, because now my baby is in a breech position. And then also one thing, I don't know if I should bring breast pump. I don't know. Okay. So basically, I don't know, like I said, I don't know if I'm going to bawa breast pump. Oh, this bag, actually my auntie got a comforter for me, for baby Kemi. I think dia beli ni daripada Mothercare di Surya Sabah. Oh yeah, and also this is a pillow that I will bring untuk kasih isap nenek. Yeah, I'm gonna bring this along with me. And also dia belikan, dia belikan 2 set of balls. I have a lot of ribbon for my daughter. Like a lot. I actually went crazy and beli every color that they have. So yeah. Breast pump ni was dibeli dan dihadiahkan from my friend. Sebenarnya dia ni dalam kotak. I think few days ago kah yang I feel like I want to try to pump my nenen. Let me know guys if I need to bring this one. Semua di dalam ni. I wanted to show you guys what I bring for myself, but there's nothing really interesting to show. What I bring is I just bring satu t-shirt, dua t-shirt, dua kain sarung, charger handphone, power bank, wall modest, tab untuk for me to main game, some snacks. I cannot live without snacks. Yeah, money, of course money. Barang mandian lah, shampoo and all. I need to pack barang-barang ni before tomorrow, because tomorrow I have to go to the doctor and see how everything is gonna be. Am I gonna do it normal or am I gonna deliver dia secara caesarean? I doubt that saya kena admit tomorrow, because tomorrow saya baru 37 weeks. I don't think so people kena caesar 37 minggu unless you ada problem, but for me, my blood pressure okay, my kandungan gula dalam badan okay, so far everything is okay, so I doubt that diorang akan admit saya tomorrow. Maybe next week after Raya. Really hoping that saya kena admit tomorrow, because I don't want to wait anymore, because I cannot wait to meet my baby. Actually, I really wanted to vlog tomorrow, but since saya berklinik di hospital kerajaan kan, so I cannot really bring any camera pergi sana. I cannot even rakam anything while di sana, even with my phone. I tried to rakam satu kali masa pergi scan, tapi tuh dokter marah saya, dia bilang, oh, tidak boleh rekam. Okay, so I'm gonna show you guys barang-barang di sini. And I'm sure you guys wanna see dia punya tempat tidur. It's just another regular baby cot, but it is special for me. But before saya kasih tengok kamu semua ni, let's just talk. And me and my husband are so susah ini masa ini PKP. Like, you guys had no idea how susah it is for us. I mean, bukan saja kami lah, I know that everyone is in the kind of same situation because of this PKP. Ada yang hilang kerja, ada yang tidak dapat pergi kerja. Okay, just in case you guys have been wondering macam mana saya boleh afford benda-benda begini. Actually, I couldn't afford pun benda-benda begini ni. Saya tidak mampu masa-masa begini, but thankfully, I have people around me who's generous enough to buy me things for baby Kemi. I couldn't buy things that I wanted for my baby, but luckily there are people who actually ask me what I want for my baby, so ada yang bagi stroller, bagi ampau. This is actually a long story about this baby cot, you know. I couldn't sleep for like a week because I know that I couldn't afford this damn baby cot, okay? Sedih kan? Yes. This is not that important. My baby can always sleep sama saya. I mean, she's not gonna be using this masa mula-mula dia lahir. She's gonna be sleeping with me. But I have this imaginasi daripada awal. I wanted to get her this. I don't know, it doesn't matter how I actually cry. Hilang selera makan, mandi tak basah, tidur tak lena. We have the money, but the money is actually for things that are really important. So I have to lupakanlah ni baby cot. And then Angel datang, which is my friend and my auntie who bought me this. I am very very lucky, like lucky. So ini semua barang-barang ini, this is not my money. This is actually barang daripada my auntie. Except for ini baju di sini. This one actually baju bundle, which if kamu belum tengok lagi saya punya video yang the one that I talk about this baju, you guys should check out the video. I will put dia punya link di description box down below, so you guys should go click and check it out and leave some comment, like and subscribe. I really wanted to buy her like a very cute gown, but for now I really cannot afford. But there are some baju yang baru, okay? Yang baru memang orang belilah, yang bundle memang saya beli because ini perempuan, she is broke. No money, but because of this baby, because of my baby, because of her, I get to makan KFC. I get to live in a house yang ada aircon, yang this is all because of her. This is all because of her. Me and my husband menumpang rezeki daripada dia ni. Me and my husband are just menumpang dia punya rezeki. People lah. Okay, let's continue. Just in case you guys are wondering why am I not working at one? We both, kami dua kerja in a nightclub. Memang club tidak dibenarkan untuk beroperasi, so we don't know. We might not gonna come back into this industry. Anyone yang senasib dengan saya, senasib dengan diri ini, just stay strong. Percaya dengan rezeki anak. You know, bersabar. If you wanna cry, just cry. I find it very hard for me to cope with any situation when you are financially not stable and then you are having a baby. It's very hard. But luckily so far, kalau mau makan KFC, makan sugar bun, makan pizza, makan, you know, semuanya termakbul lah. Thanks to my baby actually. Dia, if it's not because of dia punya rezeki, I wouldn't dapat makan yang sedap-sedap. Because semua dia punya nenek-nenek, dia punya, you know, dia punya anti-anti, semua sedih if I tidak dapat makan yang sedap-sedap. Yeah, so that's about it. So now I'm gonna show you guys what I have di belakang.
Okay, abaikan ya, abaikan yang ini. So this is actually the bed that we bought. Yeah, so sofa begini sejaklah duluan, you know. This is the rack that my auntie bought for me. Semua dia punya barang-barang. Yep. And then this is some of the things yang belum lagi buka. I have so many gifts from dia punya auntie. Sebenarnya sampai ke belakang ini, I have lagi di sana. Ada lagi di bawah sini. Another one there.
So, basically this is it. This is the bed. This is the rack. Yeah. Yep.
I haven't chat lagi yang di bahagian sini. But it's okay. Yep. Kalau kita kasih mati lampu, dia macam begini. Eh, ayo. Sorry. Tada. Well.
So yeah, basically that's it for this video. Thank you so much for tuning in. Jangan lupa subscribe to my channel because I have more video to come after this. Talk to you guys again when saya sudah mau beranak. Ataupun saya sudah beranak. I'm gonna see you next time. Selamat Hari Raya, everybody. Stay home, stay safe. Jangan spread the disease, okay? Let's fight this together because I really wanted to go to work. My husband need to work, so you guys need to stay at home and chill di rumah sahaja. Alright? Mami Kemi signing off. See you next time.